Good evening, I'm Rob Blake. Welcome to our third show for Armed Forces Entertainment, bringing you a little bit of magic all around the world. We are here at my world headquarters, where all of my illusions are built and stored, and where all my trucks are that take them to you all around the world. You can see this truck here is over 73 feet long. Now, once it is full of my illusions, it weighs over 80,000 pounds. Now, you can see this truck is completely surrounded by the building on all sides. And we even have a fence over here. There is literally nowhere this truck could go. Normally, this truck transports my illusions, but tonight, this truck will be the illusion. Go ahead, raise the curtain. You can see all around the curtain, and remember, the truck is surrounded by the building on all sides. The only way it could go, as if by magic. Drop the curtain. Now, let's start the show. Welcome to our third TV special for Armed Forces Entertainment and Armed Forces Network. We cannot still go to some of the bases around the world, so we're bringing some brand new, never before seen magic and illusions to you all around the world. This is our way of saying thank you for your service, your sacrifice. Well, let's get started. Let's do it. I'm known for performing large illusions on the biggest stages all around the world. But sometimes, for me, the most enjoyable magic is a pure sleight of hand, the things I do for my friends, people I meet, and the things I get to share on social media just for fun.
How do you fall in love?
This is our third show with Armed Forces Entertainment, my way of bringing magic to the troops all around the world when we're really not able to fully visit you with a show yet. But this time I wanted to do something extra special, something I've never done before. For the first time ever, I'm allowing you a peek back into my magic laboratory, where we create, design, and produce my illusions. For Armed Forces Entertainment, for our specials, for the shows, and for my tours all around the world. No one's ever been part of this process before. You see, when I have an idea for a new illusion, I will spend months and months researching and planning it. I will collaborate with friends who are in the magical realm and also directors and choreographers and designers and creative types to bring this vision to life. We'll take my vision after months of thinking about it, and then we'll start to draw it out into plans, into research. We'll draw some blueprints, how it might look when it first appears on stage. We'll turn this into all sorts of schematics and plans so that we all are on the same page as we move forward in the process. Like I said, it's a very collaborative process because many people are part of the show. And we'll kind of create like a vision board as we build these new illusions so we can all see it as it's coming to life, so we can all collaborate together on the new illusion. From there, before we build it in real life, we will turn it into a 3D model so we can all see and feel how it's going to look on stage. These are very large illusions. Sometimes it can take months and very expensive amounts of money to produce and bring them to life. Now, as long as I can remember, I've slept with a notebook next to my bed. This way, I can wake up in the middle of the night and write an idea. Sometimes illusions come to me in the middle of the night fully formed. This illusion you're about to see, is for the first time ever, came to me when I was about 12 or 13 years old. No one has seen this before, no one has performed it before. Here is this new illusion.
Whisper my final words down in the dirt, that's where they'll find you. Sing your chorus of lies, nowhere you can hide. I'm gonna find you. Since you opened the gates, it's your price to pay. I'm gonna find you.
A few volunteers on stage. Right here, go come up. You sure go come up. Please go all the way to the stage. And let's give them both a big round of applause. And let's meet our volunteers. What is your name, sir?
Christian.
Christian?
Rhiannon.
Christian and Rhiannon. Now, time for a survey for the audience. How many of you have ever Googled yourself before? You see, so many people have seen me on TV, on shows like America's Got Talent, and millions of people have watched my illusions online. So when I Google myself, the first thing that always comes up is, does Rob Blake have a twin brother? Well, I do not. I've got one sister. She has nothing to do with magic, but tonight I'm going to prove once and for all, I have only myself. No twin. We have a couple platforms on stage, and we're going to have our volunteers examine everything here. On each side of the stage, we have a door, and this door is raised above the stage level, so you know there's no trap doors in the stage like you might have seen in a movie. Also, each of these doors is surrounded by a security wall, so every direction you can see the table is completely isolated. On top, we have a door. And behind the door, we've got absolutely nothing. And when I close the door and open it again, we have still absolutely nothing. Now remember, you can see all around the door, and our volunteers looked below, around, and it is surrounded by a solid brick wall. Now Rhiannon, I need you to think of something random. Let's go with either a school you went to or a pet. A pet. Can you think of your first pet's name?
Snowball.
Snowball, yes? Yeah. Now, what kind of pet was Snowball?
A poodle.
Poodle, very nice. Rhiannon, take this marker. I want you to write Snowball's name really clear on my arm here. I'm branding myself so that you can all see. Take your time, write as big and clear as you can. Branding myself so you know it really is only me. Now, you can see Snowball here. We have this close-up camera. You can see this on both sides of the stage on the screens over there on each side. Snowball. Now, this is just words, Rhiannon. I want you to draw something, make this unique, make this special. Make it something really unique and special. Oh, nice heart, totally filled in. Snowball with a nice heart. I'll take that back. I want you all to remember this tattoo that Rhiannon gave me. Snowball, her first pet, her first poodle. That way you know it really is only me. Now we're gonna place the volunteers on each side of the stage so you can see this. Watch the doors from the back. Remember, there's each door surrounded by a platform, and in the middle we have a runway. This runway is a full yard apart. You can see all the way to the back. There's no way to connect the door to the door. The only way to get across will be by magic. Remember, we chose these volunteers at random. She could have thought of a school, an animal name, but you've got one more look here. Check out the screens on the side of the stage. Snowball. This will prove it really is only me. Go ahead and close the door. And now, it is my time. Once and for all, no twin, just me. I'll see you on the other side. Snowball, both sides of the stage. Give both of these volunteers a big round of applause. When I create a new illusion, sometimes I like to test it in the real world. See how it works with real people in real circumstances. This is what happens when you take real magic into the real world.
Supernatural. Oh, where did
It's an honor to get to perform for the troops with Armed Forces Entertainment. I've had several friends reach out wanting to be part of the magic and help me out, and to thank you for your support and for your sacrifice. Here's me doing a little bit of magic, having a lot of fun with one of my good friends. Hey, I am here with my friend Darcy Lynn, the winner of America's Got Talent.
Hello.
Amazing ventriloquist, singer, songwriter.
Yes.
All around incredible artist. Thank you so much for joining us for the show and to supporting the troops.
Thank you for having me. Yes, to all the troops and their families around the world. Thank you guys for your service. So excited.
Yeah, I'm so glad you're here. And we both hope to be able to come see you in person on tours at the military bases all around the world.
That would be awesome.
So Darcy's here to do one of my absolute favorite tricks in the world here with me. Darcy, I need you to think of a clock. In fact, you know, I'm going to put my watch here in the middle of this table, just so we can help think of a clock here. I want you to think of a clock on the wall. Imagine we have one of the biggest clocks in the world in front of us. And I want you to look at the clock, and I want you to see a time on the clock. Don't tell me what this time is. Just pick a time on the clock. Maybe something that has significance toward you or importance to you, or you see that number that makes you remember something and smile or feel good. Can you look around the clock and just choose a number on that clock for me? Don't tell me, but let me know if you have a number. Mm-hmm. Okay, you do?
Mm-hmm.
All right, now Darcy, forget the minutes for a second. Let's just worry about the hour only. Just focus on the hour, okay?
Okay.
Don't tell me that number. Mm-hmm. Now, we didn't prearrange this, we didn't ask, you didn't even know what you're gonna be doing today. We didn't set this up at all. We're gonna make a clock on the table here. This will be 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So we've now made a clock on the table here to represent the clock you're seeing in your mind.
Okay.
I want you to think of the memory, whatever you're thinking of the number. Don't worry about the number. Just think of what made you smile. Think of why you thought of that number. Think of that memory. Let that smile come on your face just like that. And put your hand right top of my hand. Put your hand on top of my hand. We're gonna go around the clock together. We're gonna try to see what number you were thinking of here. Focus on that memory. It's definitely a higher number, yes?
Yeah.
Okay, it's not one of the lower numbers, definitely one of the higher numbers. And it's definitely an even number.
Yes.
It's either a 10 or a, you were thinking of 12, yes?
Oh,
yeah. Amazing.
What?
Okay, but that's not all. Before I go any further, do you mind telling me what happens at 12?
It's usually when me and my best friend Lily just have a great time.
Okay. Is it 12 a.m. or p.m.?
A.m.
12 a.m., okay, a late night. Is it 12 on the dot or is it 12 a little bit adjusted?
It's a little adjusted.
Like what, 12 what?
12:30.
12:30, okay, 12:30. Now, before I began this, I wrote you a special message on the back of this card box, a little prediction. Will you turn that over? Will you turn that card box over?
Okay.
What does this say? You will not select the Joker. And if you will notice here, Darcy, the 12 o'clock card was the Ace of Hearts. It was not a Joker.
Yeah.
Now, had you thought of any other time on the clock, it would have been a Joker. There's a Joker. 1, 2, 3, 4. All of these other cards here are Jokers. All of these cards here in the rest of the deck are all Jokers.
What?
And then also, Darcy, I put my watch here at the beginning. What time is on
no
my watch
way.
Here right now.
You did not do that.
What does that say?
It's 12:30.
12:30 as well.
Oh my gosh. What?
The amazing Darcy Lynn, thank you so much for coming here, being part of the show, and doing a little bit of magic with us.
I don't even know what to say.
Thanks to all the troops at home.
Bye. What?
So after I have an idea, we put it to blueprint form and model form, and then the next step is we bring it to the workshop. This is the workshop where all of my illusions come to life. I've got an amazing team of people who help me build them, create them. We turn these blueprints, these plans, into real form, where we always have to make changes and build things around because we build it several times. We'll build a mock-up, and then we'll build it again and again until we get it just right. You see, oftentimes we've built an illusion 5 or 6 times before the audience sees it on stage, and we get to test it out. We might test it on the streets, as you saw. We might test it in a show or backstage, but it's always a process to create new illusions. One of the greatest things we've been able to do with these shows for Armed Forces Entertainment is debut new illusions that no one has seen. I've premiered some of my original creations for Armed Forces Entertainment on live tours and on these specials. Here's one more illusion, years in the making, debuting just for you in AFE. On behalf of my entire cast, crew, special guests, and most of all myself, thank you so much for joining me on this third show for Armed Forces Entertainment. And a big thanks to all of the wonderful people at Armed Forces Entertainment for allowing this to happen so we could bring magic and illusion to you all around the world, wherever you are. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for being part of the magic. Good night.